Hi friends, thank you for joining me. I haven't done a video about the earthquakes in Texas in a while. There is so many of them there, and mostly because of the fracking. Yeah, a lot of fracking. According to one of my friends, they posted there on YouTube that their earthquake alert was giving them warning messages, probably because of this magnitude 3.6. It was 38 kilometers west of Mentone, Texas. Only one person reported feeling it to USGS. Probably because you have so many of them, you just, what can you do, right? So on the felt report, they got as far as Pecos. We got Carlsbad. All the way over here is El Paso. But you actually had three today. Started out with a 3.4, then it jumped up to a 3.6, and then to a 3.0. And you know, there is a 20% chance of these earthquakes being a foreshock for something much larger. I think, in my own personal opinion, you got a larger earthquake coming. So it's not far from Mentone, Texas. This is part of West Texas. This is not far from the area in 2020 where they had a magnitude 5.0. That was on the 26th of March. This is a very sparsely populated area. Only 19 people live in Mentone. The reason that there is not very many people living in this area is because it's desert. At 5.0 was the largest earthquake recorded in that area in about 150 years. This area is what's considered the Permian Basin, which is basically sediment and rich in oil and gas production. So deep is the sediment. It is 25,000 feet of sediment that has built up in this area. USGS may say that these earthquakes are aftershocks from the 5.0. That 5.0 was on a unknown fault trending east to west. So this earthquake was 6.7 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 4.6 miles in depth or 22,000 feet. So that's within the area of sediment. Sediment in this area is about 7 miles deep. But let me pull this out. This is an area also where the plates are moving. Let me bring this out a little bit farther. Down over here to the southeast, you see the Cambrian Rift. Now that is moving southeast. This is the location of many earthquakes. Like I said, I haven't reported in a while because there's so many of them. In my opinion, it's probably from fracking. But the scientists would have to do a lot of research to find out if these earthquakes that happened today were fracking induced or normal fault shifting. Yeah, I went to the wrong area there. This is the area. If you look here, yeah, I'm not familiar with this river system, but you can definitely see there is a fault zone that would more than likely go through that area. Let me pull it up. See, we got the 3.0, the 3.4, and the 3.6. And if this is, in fact, a fault that slipped, moving going east to west, yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they're spreading here. And we'll pull it out to the location of that 5.0. If you follow the line going from east to west, you can see how these earthquakes line up with that 5.0. And then going down here a little bit south, yeah, it looks like another fault zone. Is this the fault that popped for that 5.0? Yeah, it's hard to say. But anyways, that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments? Always be prepared. Like I said, you could have a larger one, even though this 5.0 was the largest that area had in 150 years. And we know that fracking lubricates these ancient fault lines and reactivates them. So I hope all my friends are prepared for a large earthquake. Yeah, even though there's only, what, 19 people in that one town? You're probably all real good friends. Maybe even related. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.